If you're making discs, quite often it's easy to get a core cutter or support the centre and go round with whatever tools you want to go around on there. On bigger discs for plates, they tend to be not very accurate, but if you want something that's you're going to use for rotary spark gap, then you need to step up your game a little bit, and this is right for the beginners. If you use a lathe, you know, wood lathe especially, then you'll know this process essentially. Now, one of the things to remember is that first of all, you need to decide the size of your circle. This is only a small one, just as a demonstration, bit of scrap wood. But get your corners as square as possible, ideally. And I'm using a combination, a centre pointing square. You can use like this, especially if you've only got one straight edge, you can actually use a square like this, and that's what I'll use on this one actually, and you can draw your lines, and as long as that one side is actually nice and straight, you'll get your cross in the middle, which will be at 90 degrees to each other. Obviously, you ideally want a longer one. So what I'll do, I'll just extend these lines with a bigger one. Just slide it up one little bit. This is only demonstration purposes. So now I've got the centre. One of the things I'd like to do. Get a small drill, put it right on the centre line, and you can spin this by hand just to make a dimple in the middle. And obviously you want that in as centre as possible. The idea of that is so that when you put your compass on things like perspex and acrylics, it can tend to slide along unless you've got a dimple in the middle to keep it centred. So you set your compass to the diameter you want, and there's your circle. It's quite important to get your cross lines first and make sure that they are 90 degrees to each other, because these are references for when you draw your bolt holes. Obviously if you want more bolt holes, then you'll have to divide up the space accordingly. Now, next thing is to make sure that your drill is absolutely perpendicular to the surface. If you've got it a little bit off one way or the other, then you're going to have a wobbly disc, and you don't want a wobbly disc because the contacts move up and down. So how to get that perpendicular? If you have a drill press, this makes things a bit easier, but just make sure that you square it up, and you can put a bit of paper behind so you can see the gap down between the square and the rod. I actually got this bit of rod from an old printer, so it's nice and straight, so you can do your squaring up on that. And once that's vertical, if you've got one of these that's got a tilting plate on it, then you should be good to go. Get a piece of wood. It's important that one piece has got a 90 degree angle there. The more perfect that is, the better. It can be adjusted afterwards, but if you get it 90 degrees, then you're spot on. And all I've done on this is glued it together and checked it with a square in both directions, so that both those angles are vertical. Put your drill in the middle, And what I like to do is tilt it away from the block so I can bring the block in on both sides so the drill is touching on both, and then stand the drill up. Now this would be in a hand drill, you know, battery drill or whatever, and keeping it against that wood and keeping the wood held down, you can now drill a vertical vertical hole. Now, if you're like me and you want to move on to, yeah, this is a rotor from a larger motor, which I'm sort of laying out to do synchronous, you've got a larger shaft. Now, that becomes a problem because either you've got to have a larger drill or you use something like a flat bit. Problem with a flat bit, okay, they're cheap, but yeah, you try and square that up, the block isn't going to be very happy with you. So what you do is you make another one that's a bit taller and you fix your original block to that, and that allows for the blade on the spade bit to clear, and you just bring the spade bit right in, center it over your hole, keeping it all together. Obviously you're not holding the drill, but you know, your block has to be again vertical on both faces. Check it with a square. So now you've got your hole, you need to round the circle out, and typically anyone with limited tools, you would cut off the corners as close as you can, all the way around, and then any, you know, that'll leave other corners, so you cut those corners off. And you get it as close to the line as possible without actually touching the line. And that gives you an idea of where your circle is. The hole in the middle, obviously you'd be for your shaft size, you want that as tight as you can. A nice press on fit is a good thing. And you end up with a disc. Now I know this disc is slightly out. This is off of the old double banger disc, as double bang spark gap. Give you a better shot of what we're doing. Okay, so you want to pick a line that's below centre. Now it's nice to go, I got the nut in the middle there, so we're going to choose a point that's roughly where the bottom of that nut is. Then you get a block of wood. Now if this is on a base, you know, a flat base, then you'd want to stand it on the table and somehow clamp it. Or if you've got a vertical surface like I've got on here that supports the motor, then that's ideal. So you pick it about level with the below centre. Yeah, you can use clamps, you can use screws, it doesn't really matter, as long as you've got the block solid and your motor mounted and solid. I'm just going to clamp this to the table so nothing moves. Now you need to turn this. I don't know if you can see that there is a slight wobble in this disc, it's only very slight, but you can get tools. You know, I've got lathe tools, but I'm not going to use lathe tools today. I'm going to use an old beater chisel. It's actually got little notches in there where I've hit nails. I've used this for levering pieces of wood apart and going to hammer it in sometimes. So this is just my beater chisel. I've got some decent ones in the drawer which I'm not going to use for this. And you want your edge, at least in some part of it, you know, sharp enough, because all you're doing really here is scraping. So I've got this on the variac, if I spin that slowly, you'll probably be able to see. Look at the very edge of it, there is a bit of a wobble there. And if I bring the chisel in, bring the speed up a little bit. Now you can hear it missing parts on there. So now all you do is take your chisel in and scrape it away. Now you don't, the reason why you got this down low is because you don't want to be putting the chisel upwards, because that will just bite into the disc and knock out junk, split it in half or whatever. So try and keep it about level or slightly below and you'll be okay. You probably hear that getting a bit smoother in its rotation, and I can already see it's much better. Now, what happens if you haven't got a chisel? Well, just about any piece of metal will suffice. And yeah, we've got a screwdriver there. Nice square edge on there, hopefully not a rounded edge, otherwise it won't work very well. Let's just see what this does. It is taking shavings off, but it's very slow. As I say, this one's actually got a bit of a rounded edge on it. It should be nice and square on it. But yeah, it will work. The other thing that you can use is something like a surf form. These are a bit like a cross between a file and a plane, but they got multiple teeth on there. I would only use this once I got rid of all the lumps and it's getting close to smooth. You rest it on the block and you can bring it in gently in a controlled manner. What you don't want is the file to be doing this. Whether you use a surf or a file, you want to bring it in so it just touches and you're getting rid of the high spots all the time. Now, the other thing to do with balance, making sure it doesn't wobble too much, is getting your bolts in the right place. Now, I've already got bolt holes in here because it was used on the other disc, but all you need to do on that, get your corner of a tool, chisel, whatever, and just rest it gently, and you can make a mark in the edge. Okay. Get a groove there. I've got another pencil. Not ideal to use one of these felling pencils because they break easily, but to highlight the line, you put the pencil in there. So now we've got a balance wheel, we've got a line which runs exactly the same distance from the centre, and as long as you put the same bolts in all positions, and you should have a balance wheel. So there you go, let's hope that's been helpful to you, and you'll be able to get a nice RSG.